Okay, so what we have here is the Panasonic VCR. I lose half the screws there. This Panasonic VCR is their high-end video recorder from back in the 90s. The VCR itself is obviously a Panasonic. It's the NV-HS900B. Now, this one is not working. Here's the front of it here now. But this particular machine is not working. I don't know what the problem is with it. So I'm going to take it apart anyway and show you what I did with it. How I broke it even further, I suppose. Anyway, this particular machine, I'm just going to show you some of the basics of it. How to take it apart, how to put it back together again. I think it's been covered before by other guys on YouTube, how to clean them, how to maintain them. So there's probably not going to be much ground that's changed here, but I'm going to try and add a few bits into this video in an effort to explain how this machine comes apart, how this machine goes back together again. Now I've already taken most of it apart, as you can probably see, but these are the easy bits. Taking the cover off is not really a problem. There's four screws, two on either side. Just undo them, and then just basically lift both sides slightly, pop it back, and out it comes. There are four screw holes, and two on the other side, obviously. The inside of the machine, which you can see here, is die-cast aluminium, which has been mentioned before. It's quite an advanced little machine, to be honest with you. What you have here is you've got the video head itself. Now, this particular video head, like all video heads and all VCRs, does both the recording and the readback of the video itself. So basically you have the audio head, which I mentioned before, you got the arrays head, and then you got your six head main read and write head. So generally when the tape comes in, it'll be arrayed by this fella and written by this, and the audio will be written by this baby. That's the way it works. On the other way around then, what happens is you're just basically, well, it's not bypassing, it's still rubbing off this, but the video has been read by the head and the audio has been read by the audio head, as if it were. Now, one thing to remember on these machines is that if you are working on them, try working a dull light or put the cover back on, even without the screws, because sometimes if you try to put the videotape into it, it will refuse to take it, and you may think that's a fault. It's not. It's very light sensitive in here, so it tends to happen on this model. I didn't find it happening on other models, but I did find it happening on this particular Panasonic. I'm just going to turn it around there a bit, just try to get a nicer shot for the video. Taking the actual mechanism out is quite straightforward. I generally use a videotape to do it. So, we start off with the basics here. As I said, first thing to do is to take out the screws. Now, there are four screws. There's the red one here. You want to make sure that one goes back in that spot when you're finished as well. So, there's four screws. That's one of them. Second screw is... I'll turn it around again here, so as you can see. Second screw is this one down here. Okay, so it's now going to just undo that one. Now there's actually a piece missing off this at the moment. I took it out of here already. It's a little piece that sits in here, and this is it. It's actually off another one. It's not off this particular one, but it's the same piece. And basically, heat sits on there. And what happens is that when the machine starts off, this little fella here, as you can see, there's plenty of dirt on it. This little fella here bumps off the video head and gives it a little clean. Now, I actually cleaned this video head, and it's still ongoing. The amount of dirt I took off this video head is not even funny, and it's still dirty. It's still got dirt on it, you know. Yeah. Anyway. The way to clean the video head is a bit of alcohol on a piece of paper, hold it to it gently, and move it around. Okay, I know I mentioned in another video about going up and down rather than this way. I actually contacted the last guy I know that actually fixes VCRs. I don't fix VCRs, I don't know much about them. I'm only going to show you what I know here. I contacted him to ask him about repairing the VCR, this particular one here. And he said basically that he had retired and he wasn't doing them anymore. Now, there is another guy that I know of that may fix them, but it means I have to spend yet more money on this VCR. And to be honest with you, it's not really worth it. I've got one working, I can use this one as spare parts if the other one happens to fail, so I'm not really going to worry about it too much. The actual mechanism in this is working okay, so, you know, I'm not going to worry about it that much. Okay, so he's taken the two screws out the back. We still haven't got the carriage free yet. There's two more screws in here. There's a screw here and underneath here. Now, the way I get them out is I just put videotape in just a bit, like so. Just hold the mechanism slightly with my other hand. I can then shove that in a bit. It's two screws, so there's a screw down here. So I'll try to lift that up to show you. Might see it down that hole down here. It's over here. Okay. I'll do a zoom in on that in a moment here. And there's another screw just here. So I'm going to take these two screws out. You can let the carriage relax there for a minute. It doesn't really matter. Won't do it any harm. That screw out. And this is the location of the other screw, this fella down here. So you want to also remove this fella. Okay, see him? See him down there? Can't miss him. So I'm going to remove him now. Now that all the screws are taken out, hold on there for a second. Now all the screws are taken out. What you want to do is take the actual mechanism out itself. You want to lift this out. But before you lift it out, you've got to take off a couple of cables. If you just try to lift this out as it stands, you'll find, you know, a lot of the cables don't want to come with it. Don't want to play ball. So a few cables to take out. I'm just going to come out there a bit now. Okay, so the cables you want to take out are this cable here on the raise head. The one here on the head amplifier. It's this one here. This is stuck into the board itself directly. And then there's this cable here then stuck into the audio read head. Once those cables are removed, you can then simply lift. I'm stuck on something. Sorry, there's another cable down here. I forgot about this one. Take it out from the bottom, actually. Yeah. It's actually handy to take it out once you lift the carriage out a bit. But once you've done that, you're good to go. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cables to remove. And then the whole mechanism will come out. Okay, so now we've got the mechanism out of the machine. What do we want to look for? What do we want to do on this machine? Well, you want to oil up these babies here, put a drop of oil, not WD-40, carriage oil from doing the carriage bars and printers, that's what I used. So I oiled, put a bit of oil in that, put a bit of grease on the top here along this, and then I turned the beauty over, and I put a bit of grease in here, put a bit of grease in all this bit here, a bit of grease along here, greased up this and greased up this. Now the other particular model, the other particular machine, greased up here and greased up here. Okay, so the other machine that I actually got cables in, this is actually a nice little notched belt as well, so pretty good. But the other machine that I got, let's go back to that again for a minute, had been serviced already, so I didn't do any of this greasing or taking it apart like I did on this particular machine. Now, if you want to take the video head out of this machine, the process I'll now show you how to do, because what's happening with this machine is that I'm getting no picture on the screen. So I figured that maybe in my process of taking the whole machine apart, that I damaged the video head in some shape or form. Maybe I hit off or I bumped off or took a lump off one of the heads. So I basically said, right, anybody got a spare video head, I'll give it a go myself first. It's not the problem. But it's very simple to get a video head out of this, so I'm going to show you how that's done. It's not going to matter to this one. I'm still going to be very careful with the head because this is a good head. And the other head I suspect is in good nick as well. So I reckon I've got two good video heads and obviously the one the machine that's working too. So let's go ahead and take the first steps to taking the video head out. Okay, well right down here there's a little screw. So I'll get the I'll point to it. See this little screw down here? I'll take that screw out first. So I'll take this little arm off. Okay, so just be very careful when you're taking these things out because you don't want to smack off the head and take a lump out of it. That's the last thing you want to do. So let's take that out of there very carefully. I know you can't see much of my great big hand is in the way. There we go. So you see, little screw on there. Yeah, I haven't managed to take a lump out of my video head. So this particular head amplifier is easy enough to get out. It's the next piece you need to take out. You take that out by, see the two red screws? So you got a red screw here. You got a red screw here. So take those two out next. So again, my hand's in the way, I know, but I need to just put a bit of pressure here. Now, the tip would be that when you're taking screws out of a machine, whether it be a PC or a VCR or whatever, is to put them into a section or write them down where they are. Or in this modern day and age, you can take little photographs so you know where everything went. The head itself will just, or this is the lamp before, but just come up, just give it a little bit of a pull, gentle pull, up it comes. So, it's the head amplifier out of there. So, that's working fine. Next thing you need to do is turn over the mechanism again and we'll have a look at the back of it again. Okay, the video head itself is held in with three screws, so there's one, two and three. So when you're taking the video head out, put your hand underneath it because you don't want it to, so you've got, basically you're coming in from this side as if it were and putting your hand underneath to hold the bottom of the head, or the top of the head as if it were, and then just undo those three screws. So this screw here, this screw here, and that screw there, and the video head will come dropping out. To reinstall the head, it's reverse of what I've just done. Be very careful when you're putting the head back in as well, and when you're tightening the screws, just don't over tighten screws. Never a good thing. The old saying goes, hand tighten, so nice and gentle that comes out. So now we have the video head out of the mechanism, so we'll now lift this up. I don't want to touch the video head really. This is the video head now, come back into the view. So this is your video head. So I'm amazed how well they're made, you know what I mean? The beauty of them is something else, you know. Just like them, they look pretty fancy. I'm about to put a big fingerprint on there now, taking it out. That won't do any harm. Quick clean the video head. We'll show you how to clean the video head now in a second. But a quick clean the video head will sort that out. It's not really any problem. So anyway, this is the video head out of it. So I suspected that this was faulty. Like I said, I bought a second one. This is actually the second one, just in case you're wondering. I'll take out the other one, just to show you that I'm not winding you up as if it were. Actually, I suspected it might have been the cable too, from this cable here. I suspected it might have been this cable here from the head amplifier to the actual board itself. Alas, it was not. And here's the other head. I suspect that head's working perfectly. I suspect there's nothing wrong with it whatsoever. I have a funny feeling that both video heads are spot on. I don't think they're the problem at all. I think the problem is with the mechanism somewhere. I don't know where, mind you, but I suspect that's where the problem is. I did actually notice one thing on these two heads. It's actually slightly different. The big hole in the back of that one. cylinder drive series numbers, that sort of crack are all the same though, so there's doesn't appear to be any problems there. So anyway, that's the other video head, so I'll put that one back. I suspect that it's working fine. It might not be. This one here might be working fine. So we're going to reassemble the VCR now completely, because I'm going to put this back into storage for the moment. So we now reassemble the full thing, and you never know, it might actually start working this time. So I'm going to put the video head back in here because it's very undignified. I'll videotape it. If it turns out to be shocking, I'll just skip over it and pretend it went in magically, like Blue Peter. Okay, so I think I have it in the right position for the screws to go back in, so I'm just going to see. Gentle turn. Yep, she's grabbing. Okay. Final little hand tight. And a final little hand tight. So, the video head is back in place. So let's flip her back over. And have a look at the seed. Yes, I have noticed actually that the VCR, this particular one from Panasonic, compared to their later models, is definitely a fairly robust piece of machinery. On the newer models, this whole base plate here, as you might have seen even in the Sony ones, is actually plastic. I'd say that was to do with a cost-saving exercise. I wouldn't say it was for any other reason. I'd say it was just purely like, yeah, we can save money here by, you know, putting in plastic instead of the old, good lord. That's gone missing down there. Easy to sort out. Just lift that out of the way. There it is there. Actually, it's probably easy to put that arm back on first. Oh, good lord. Than it is to put this in place. You wanna, actually, I think we might do that. Put the arm on first. What do you reckon? Yes. Gently, gently, gently. Probably easier to get this baby back on. I'll turn it around there so maybe you guys can see it. Yeah, it's also, oh good lord, I'm butterfingers here, isn't it? Absolutely, butterfingers. Just be careful you don't scrape this off the video head. The video heads are designed to be shiny. That's part of the allure, I was going to say. That's part of the reason why they work. They have to be shiny. So just get that in position. It's in position. Just make sure it is in position. It is in position, yes. Yes, extra crispy. Let's continue with that. Make sure it's in the right spot. Sport on, old chap, sport on. Yep, okay, that looks okay to me. Not that I know what I'm doing, but it looks okay to me, so that's good enough. So we can put that back in there now again. Yeah, this is working out very well, isn't it? So that's easy enough to do. Okay, so next, these two babies here. So this time we're trying to drop them into the mechanism. Actually, yeah, I do recommend you put this on first and then put this in. It is actually easier to do. A bit more space. It's also easier to do this with the, obviously, well, it'd be impossible to do it with it in the machine. But if you were to just change even this or change, you know, this, you know, it's a hell of a lot easier to do when it's outside the case, that's for sure. Having some trouble here with this baby. There we are. The screw doesn't go in, no matter what it is or where you're doing it. If it doesn't go in properly the first time or that, just take it a little bit slower. And just gently try to put the screw in. It should meet in nicely. You shouldn't have to, you know, strip the screw. If it's not going in easily, then don't force it in. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. I'm just going to get the other part to put this back into the VCR. Okay, as I was saying, it isn't working, and I don't know why. I did actually suspect this might be faulty, this particular cable, but no, it's not that. I'm just going to put these out of the way. It's actually, I find it easier when you want to put it back together. Now, don't forget, we've got a cable to go in down here. So actually, I'll tell you, we'll take the back of that for a moment. I actually remember now, I found it easy to put this cable in first, so we're gonna try and what you need here are smaller hands, really. Big builder's hands aren't exactly the ideal situation for this. So putting the back in is actually straightforward, and I'll make it look more difficult. There's actually little guide bars, little plastic guide bars sticking up, so it actually goes in fairly snug. So that's it, really. This cable here. So you got five cables. You got one in. So that's one. This is number two. Number three. Number four. Last but very not least, number five. So now all the cables are back in. So as I was saying about the video head, how do you clean the video head? Piece of nice white paper. Here's one I used before. Put a little drop of alcohol on. Oh, good Lord. Just place it against the head gently. And just a little bit of pressure with your finger. Spin the head. And you should get a bit of dirt off. We're going to get that fingerprint back off that we put on by... So go this way just as you can see it. Yeah, that should be better for you now. So there'll be a bit of dirt in there. Now, the other bit... Still filthy, this head. It's amazing the amount of dirt is coming off it. I'm just going to use the dry part for a minute just to dry it up. Yeah, look at that, look. I can't imagine, like, the other video head on the other machine that's working is still got dirt on it as well, but it's playing back the video. So that's why I'm suspecting that it can't just be the video. It has to be something else more major has gone wrong here. This machine is a problem somewhere else. If anybody out there is a proper expert, unlike myself, and knows a lot about VCRs and wants to leave a comment below as to how to fix this beauty, I'd be very much appreciative of it, because I, for the love of God, can't figure out what's wrong with this thing. But like I said, I'm no expert. So, that's the end of that. As you can see, I'm no expert. Anyway, that'll do. So, I'm now going to show you how to put the front bezel back on. There's a few little pitfalls that I noticed when I was doing it, so I'm hoping to show how that's done. But before we do that, we must screw it back together into the mechanism. Now, like I said already, just be very wary if you're messing with these machines that you have the power unplugged for a start. But I'm presuming you've done all that. If you're playing with these machines and you have the cover off, you may also find that they don't want to play ball. They don't want to accept the tape, or, you know, like this one here originally wouldn't even take a tape. It was just point blank refused. So that's why I oiled it all up. I put a drop of oil actually in the top here as well and let it sink in. So this was working a little bit better. But I find it is a good mechanism, but it's a very chunky, clunky mechanism. And I'm kind of wondering to myself, like, you know, why is it so clunky? But anyway, what was I going to say there? You might notice there that I'm putting the screws in just gently. I do recommend you do that. Just put the screws in. You know, that's pretty off camera a bit there, isn't it? I'll just show you how I did that again. So when I get these two screws in here at the front, I put that in just a bit. I just put my finger on this little bit of plastic here, see? So now I have access to the screw here and I have access to the screw down here. Actually shove that carriage in all the way if I want. Feel free to jam something in there if you want, so it doesn't take the finger off you. It's really up to yourself. This will probably go flying in here now, won't you say? I'm going to attempt to get that screw in down there without it dropping, and it did drop. That's why you need magnetic headed screwdrivers. I'll be back in a minute when I fish that screw out, because it's going to be very undignified. Okay, what I did was I fished it out, yes, and then I magnetized my screwdriver just a little bit. All the years of working on PCs, etc., I've never had a problem with a screwdriver that was magnetized. This is the screwdriver I've been using since Jesus was a boy, and it's just become demagnetized. Not anymore, as you see. So I just rub a magnet off and it's magnetized again. If you're afraid that a magnetized screwdriver will do harm to your electronic equipment, by all means be afraid. That's fair enough. It's a fair enough thing to be worried about. It's an alright thing to be worried about. There's no problem. But you're having problems putting screws into, you know, mechanisms like this to keep on dropping. Put a bit of blue tack on the end of your screwdriver, or whatever similar substance you may have, and that'll help you out. So yeah, that's the four screws in. So that one's in, that one's in. Make sure that was nice and tight there. Let's tighten that one up, finish it off. That's your four screws in. So now we are good to go. So now we'll go and have a look at the front of the machine and see how we put the cover back on the front here. Okay, it's kind of a hard one to explain, but you got to make sure that this piece of plastic here is in the right position for the cover. Because when you're putting the... Hold on. Whoop. when you're putting the cover back on, you want to make sure the door still opens up. So I found by just putting the door on slightly, but basically you're trying to get this piece here cut the end of that so it can open. You'll see it when you're playing with it. If you're able to take it apart, you'll get what I mean. But just watch out for this bar here when you're putting the cover on, because you want to make sure that the door can still open. So I generally have the door open when I'm doing it, that way it's in the right position, so it's above it. The door will close fine and everything is okay. That's generally, so I have the door open like that, and then I put the cover back on the front of it. When you're taking this cover off, I usually start at one side and then basically pop the clips off and just loosen it off and away it comes. Before you take the cover off, the one thing to note is the two little covers here on this little switch, this little jog switch. Couldn't put it into that box. I put it into this one. Yes it is, there it is. Okay, so you've got two little pieces here that go on the front, so you've got that in there like that. So I just found by just putting the flathead behind it, it's prising up slightly, I could pop that one off, and then the other one then just popped off as well. First time I did it, I forgot about it, and the cover popped them off for me anyway. Whoops. Okay, so like I said, putting the front on is really not a problem. It is fairly straightforward. I'm not going to put the cover back on it because I might do a bit more work on this. But it is straightforward. Just watch out for this little fella here. So what we'll do now is I'll put the cover back on it. I can't show you any video playing back up from it because it doesn't want to play back any video. I don't know what the problem is, but I hope this video has been informative. I hope you've learned something from it, and I'll just show you various video shots of the machine in action. It may work with the cover off, so I'm going to try that first because the lighting here isn't that bright. If it doesn't, well, then you won't be able to see the inside of it. So I'll say goodbye now. So goodbye, good luck, thanks for watching, and if I put in a little bit at the end, then continue watching to the end and enjoy a little bit of motorized action. Yes, always like a bit of motorized action.